So hello everyone, welcome back to the ATModel channel. Today we will unbox and reveal about a kit from Trumpeter, the SA-6, or also known as the 2K12 cuff. This is an anti-air missile system from the Russian army in 1/35th scale. Well, the price of this kit is pretty cheap here where I live, only about $14. Outside, on top of the box, we have a very nice illustration of the vehicle. Also, there is information about the vehicle and the kit as well. And open up the box, there is actually a very nice single page that is color printed. I really appreciate it because for this price, there's some manufacturers they don't color printed it. And actually on the page it's showing the camel pattern, and this is also a color coded for reference. They did not actually set what brand here, but based on the color coded I would say that this is Mr. Hobby color. How do I know that? Because I have this color. Now, as you can see here, the real colors from the bottles and the printed manual is very far off. So it's just a reference, and the color suggested from the bottle is not also very accurate with the reference photos that I found on it. Okay, I will do this three color camel pattern with two tone of green and one shade of brown. Oh, the plastic itself, the quality feels kind of okay, but a little crunchy. It's not a tamer yet at all, but overall it's well casted, not many recess area, and yeah, we have nice detail on the side and on the top here. Well, the bottom section is made with a battle style, feels sturdy enough, but I think there might be some gaps issue when we gluing it with the top section. We might need some putty for the gaps. This is the turret runner, nicely casted with many detail. Some parts for the front, rear and side armor, no problem with the plastic so far. This is the missile runner, cast it into half pieces. We have to be very careful when gluing them together, because there's definitely some gaps over here. We must use putty for these. This is the ammo and accessory small detail runner. Very well done and nicely detailed. Consider the price range for this kit is only about $14-$15. It's feel very crunchy. But it's feel very crunchy. It's not soft and spongy like Tamiya plastic at all. Would need to be very careful when handling them. Now this is the track runner, not movable obviously, and there's some third party movable track kit out there for upgrade, but for this build I will just use the robotic. This is the water slide decal, a little bit thicker than the other brands. As I want to do this kit with Vietnam Army marking and insignia, I will not use the marking. They are for Russian and Croatia vehicle. We have a very simple photo edge assist or PE for the engine cover, the side panels, and some hinges. This is good enough for a $14 spend. Inside there's a little plastic bag and there's a rubber hose for the missile electrical wire. You can see here what I mean by crunchies of plastic. Well, when I slide my hobby knife around the gate, it's not like cut off very smoothly and it's come off very hard and then snap suddenly. the holes that they drill on the side of the top section is not lined up, so I have to drill another hole. It's about 1 millimeter up, so it's okay, because when we glue it, it totally cover up that hole. Well, the missile base will movable because you can set up the missile to be either in standby or in transportation position. And for the missile fingers guys here, there is a little bit different between the left and the right, so be careful when gluing them. I made a mistake here and I have to separate the left and the right fingers after painting to correct it up. And the two edges of the missile pieces were rising up a little bit for easier alignment. After gluing and then sanding them out, it looked quite okay, but the top area were like near the tip of the missile, that area totally needs some pretty work. After letting the putty to cure for about 24 hours, I check and I see that the putty had dried up pretty good, no sunken area, so I use the hobby knife to scrape up some excess putty. And then I used the 600 grit sanding paper to even the surface, and after that 1000 and 1500 grit sponge to smooth the surface. Finally, I used the Mr. Hobby Surfacer 1500 to spray on the seam line to check if there is still any visible gap. And this one's okay already. The seam has totally gone. It's good enough for painting. And thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Painting this vehicle. Please like and subscribe if you see the content helpful. See ya.